一定要 show you guys how to prove that if f is differentiable at a, then f has to be continuous at a. In another word, we're saying differentiability implies continuity. However, the converse of this statement is not true. We cannot just say if f is continuous at a, then f has to be differentiable at a. That's not true, because an example is that the absolute value of x, it is continuous at 0, but absolute value of x is not differentiable at 0. Be sure you guys check out my other video for a more detailed explanation, and the link will be in the description for you. And this right here is just a nice exercise that mainly tests our definitions and how to formulate a proof. So I'll show you guys how to do that. And of course, first we have to review the definitions, because without the definitions, we cannot do any proofs. So right here, when we have f being differentiable at a, this simply means that we know f prime of a, the derivative of f at x is equal to a, this right here exists. That's pretty much it. And I'm just going to leave that over there for now. And right here, this is what we're trying to show. F is continuous at a, and remember the definition is that the limit as x approaching to a of the function, in order for f to be continuous at a, the limit when x is approaching to a of the function has to be equal to the value of the function. So the limit is equal to f of a. In other words, you can simply plug in a into x and you get a limit for that answer. That's pretty much it. But anyway, this is what we're trying to show. And usually we'll start from the left-hand side and then try to show the right-hand side. If we can achieve that, we'll be done for the proof. And of course, this is the given condition. Somewhere we must use the condition in our proof. Otherwise, you know you are doing something wrong. Anyway, THM stands for theorem, and PF stands for proof. And this is what we're trying to show. So we start from the left-hand side. So let's go ahead and put down the limit as x approaching a. And we have f of x, of course. And you're going to find yourself you don't have a lot of things to work with. So this is the part that you really have to think hard. You have this on the left-hand side. I really want to just plug in a into x, but I cannot do that. I must somehow use this. And in fact, I haven't put down the complete version of this. Earlier, I just told you guys that I can write down f prime of a exists. But keep in mind, this right here, I can write it down as a limit as well. Because right here, we have limits already. Why don't we put down the limit definition of this as well, right? In other words, f prime of a, I can write this down as the limit as x approaching a. And notice I'm using this version because we have this version already, x approaching a, right? So this right here, it's equal to the limit as x approaching a, and we have to put down the difference quotient. So this is f of x minus f of a, and then bottom we have x minus a. So we know that this right here exists because we are given that we have f being differentiable. In other words, this right here has to be a nice number. It cannot be undefined whatsoever. So let's see if there's any connection that we can make. Well, we have this part at the moment. We want to begin with this. And if you look at the top, we want to have f of x minus f of a. I want to have this right here, so I can somehow use this form. So what can I do? Well, right here, I am going to subtract, but it's okay, because as long as I add something after that, I can pretend nothing happened, right? So that's the strategy. First, I will still write this down as the limit as x approaching a, and let's open a big parenthesis. Inside here, I will first write down f of x, nothing new, but now I want to invite this guy to here, so let me just minus f of a. But as I said earlier, I cannot just take away without giving back. So I will just add f of a immediately, like this. So of course, this is still the same as that. OK, now, let me erase this a little bit. Anyway, this right here, I really wish that I can divide this by x minus a so that this is going to be in that form, isn't it? And why don't we just make that happen? Let's go ahead and do that. And by the way, right here, one of the limit laws says when you have a limit of a sum, I'm going to break it down into this part plus this part. So it's the sum of two things. So I'll just write down, this is the first parentheses, this is the second parentheses. The limit of the sum, it's a sum of limits. So first, let me just put down the limit of this right here first. I will write down the limit as x approaching a, and let me just write this down right here, f of x minus f of a. So that's this part. And then I'm going to add, I will put the limit for this guy, the limit as x approaching a, and this is just simply f of a, like that. Well, this part is this part. Well, I want to just divide it by x minus a. And notice that I can do this because when I say x is approaching a, x is not exactly a, so this is legit. But this right here, it's totally different than that. So what do I have to do? It's okay, because I divide it, I can just go ahead and multiply this so I can pretend nothing happened again. So this is now a limit of a product. Well, that's the same as the product of two limits. This right here, I can break it down for you guys again. And next we see that this is what? This is just f prime of a, isn't it? So we can totally write that down for this part, f prime of a. And better yet, we know this right here has to be a nice number because we're given that f is differentiable at a. So this limit must exist. In another word, this has to be a nice number. And the second part right here is that we have the limit as x approaching a, x minus a. This is just as nice because x minus a is linear, so it's continuous. In another word, to calculate this limit, you can just legitimately plug in a into x. So we get a minus a. And of course, this is going to be 0 because thanks to a minus a. And then, of course, this limit right here, notice f of a is just a number. This right here is just a number. I don't know what the number is, but it's just a number. And when you take the limit when x approaching to whatever of a constant right here, a number, it's just the number. So the limit of this right here is simply f of a. So I did do the limit, and the limit is just this number. And finally, we're saying what? This times 0 plus f of a. So of course, this is just 0, and then we add f of a. And lastly, we can say the whole thing is just f of a. And you see that we began with the limit as x approaching to a, f of x. And we did all that work. In the end, we see we have f of a. And that's exactly what we're trying to show. And we did it. So now we are done. So you can put a box and shade in and be happy. That's it.